BlueCat Address Manager's role-based access control permits the admin to control who can make changes to the environment and ensure that only authorized changes are made to the DDI ecosystem. Let's dive right in. When you're configuring this, we only want to permit certain members of groups to have rights to specific DHCP areas and DNS. So our requirements is for our user to be able to create, manage, and delete host records, CNAMEs, and MX records, as well as the ability to manage our DHCP ranges and reservations from a create, manage, and delete perspective. All right, to start, we're going to validate that our user C Brown, the user we're going to use to check our rights, doesn't have permissions up front. So we're going to go and log in. All right, and here you can see we don't even have the ability to click into anything other than groups at the time being. All right, so this obviously shows me that we don't have permissions. So what I'll do is log out from here and we'll go change their permissions accordingly, and then we'll check back after making those changes. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna click on administration here at the top, right? And we'll click on configurations here on the left-hand side. And here we'll select the appropriate config. For mine, I'm gonna use default configuration. And we're gonna scroll down towards the bottom and you see here it says new access rights. Right, so we're gonna click on new access right. Right, and from here in our drop-down box, we can go and click on the down arrow and it will provide the users that are listed in the address manager as well as the group. So we're going to use a group, right? We're going to click add. All right, now, so we're given the default ability to see everything, but we don't want them to be able to change everything. So what we're going to do is we're going to control these. So we're going to give IP address for V4 and we're going to say add, right? And we're going to say IP DHCP, we want to be able to do full access on, so then we'll be able to delete, add, or change. We're going to do the same for IPv6. All right. We're going to scroll a little further down, and we only want to be able to have alias, host records, and MX records per kind of our stated requirements. We're going to say, okay, cool, you have full access rights to that, so you can add, change, delete, whatever you might need. All right, so now we're going to scroll down to the very bottom here and go in and click add. All right, and scroll down, we validate now. Hey, here's our access rights. You can see it has default view, and there is some overrides in that policy. All right, so we're gonna click back up here to the very top, click log out. We're gonna log in with that user C Brown. That's a member of that user admins group. All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go into our IP space first to validate that we can change the DHCP stuff. All right, so we're gonna click on DHCP here at the very top. All right, so here's our existing DHCP range. So we're gonna go and click into this. What we're gonna do is change the size of our range by adding an exclusion. All right, so 192.168.0, we're gonna say 55, and we're gonna end at 59, all right? Add, awesome, and we're gonna hit update here. All right, great. Now, what we've done is we've locked down their ability to modify the scope. They can, however, delete it and add new ones, but we saw we are able to modify an existing range as well, right? We do this exact same thing on IPv6. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna go click on DNS and we're gonna go to validate that that functions there as well. All right, we're gonna go internal, com, and DD lab. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna click on the plus button here, and now we see we have the ability to add a host record, alias, or MX. So we're gonna add a host record. All right, we're just gonna call a test for the time being. We're saying 192.168.0.248. We're gonna hit add, and we're gonna scroll down here to the very bottom and click add again. Awesome, so now we can see our new host record here on the bottom. And just to validate, we're able to delete records as well. We're gonna go in and hit delete. All right, great, it says, hey, do you wanna delete this? Yes. All right, awesome. There we go. And now we've been able to limit those permissions for this user and provide kind of the required results. And that's BlueCat Address Manager's role-based access control. Visit BlueCatNetworks.com to learn more.